November 1621. By now, the white man has arrived in great numbers, not only at Miami, but at Jamestown, at Plymouth, and at Salem, Massachusetts. The Puritans have established a thriving colony, enjoying all the social and cultural refinements of a modern society.
Hiya, Harv. Who are you taking to the witch burning Saturday night?
Prudence Adams. Who are you taking to the Rotary Club luncheon?
I haven't got a date yet, but I hear it's going to be quite a spread.
Well, Mayor Pennypacker, how's it look for re-election?
Great, great, great. Never looked better.
Yeah, what about the Indian vote?
What do you mean by that?
Well, you're not too popular with the Indians. They could lose you the election.
That's possible.
Well, they outnumber us.
Well, that's the trouble. You give them an inch and they take over.
But, Mayor, they were here before we were. We moved in on them.
So we did. Well, there's just something about them. They wear funny shoes. They don't even have buckles on them.
Be that as it may, election is Friday. You better make some gesture this week.
Like what?
Well, how about if you make a concession and pick an Indian as a running mate? You'd be sure to carry the Indian block.
What? Anything happened to me, you'd have a mayor that wasn't a Puritan. He'd probably take orders directly from Chief Powhatan.
Yeah.
Say, I got it. The big luncheon tomorrow, the one under the trees.
What about it?
We'll ask an Indian. That'll impress the rest of them.
We could even announce you're going to put one in your cabinet.
No need to go that far. Just have one to lunch.
It'll be great press.
Mayor Pennypacker comes out for equality. Justice. Votes.
What a slogan. Take
an Indian to lunch this week. Show him we're a regular bunch this week. Show him we're as liberal as can be. Let him know he's almost as good as we. Make a feathered friend feel fed this week. Overlook the fact he's red this week. Let him share our Quaker oats, 'cause he's useful when he votes. Take an Indian to lunch.
2, 4, 6, 8, who do we tolerate? Indians, Indians, rah, rah, rah. Take an Indian to lunch this week. Let him sit right down and munch this week.
Let's give in and all do the brotherhood bit. Just make sure we don't make a habit of it. Take an Indian to dine this week. Show him we don't draw the line this week. We know everyone can't be as American as we. After all, we came over on the Mayflower. Take an Indian, not a wooden Indian, but a real life Indian to lunch.
Needless to say, the luncheon there under the trees was a great success, and a good time was had by Puritans and Indian alike. Everything came off beautifully, with the exception of one minor catastrophe.
What do you mean you cooked the turkey, Charlie?
Well, I cooked the turkey, that's all.
You put our national bird in the oven, is that correct?
Yeah, well,
and
I...
all of us had our mouths set for roast eagle with all the trimming.
Yeah, well, I...
You did a thing like that?
Well, the two birds were lying there side by side.
The turkey was for the centerpiece, Charlie. I mean...
Well, they looked so much alike
we blew it now. They're all sitting down at the table out there.
Yeah, yeah.
Started on their little nut cups. Already. We just have to switch the birds, that's all.
Yeah, well...
Serve them turkey instead of eagle. But it's kind of scrawny looking, isn't it?
Yeah, well, I thought I'd stuff some old bread in it and make it look a little fatter.
You do that, okay?
Okay.